Power Girl Power Trip is one special book. It follows the adventures of Power Girl as she tries to settle in her new life in New York City, which isn't all that easy when you're being hunted by body-snatching monkeys and amorous aliens and armies of animal men. Power Girl is also trying to figure out who she is and what her place in the world is because she's got a ton of conflicting backstories, all kind of being, confronted. In the end, it's Psycho Pirate who's trying to drive her crazy, who actually helps her sort out all this mess. You see, Power Girl is kind of like this go-to character DC has, but they weren't really sure what to do with her because she kind of started out like a Supergirl clone. So here you see she's like, no, I'm from Krypton. I'm Supergirl. No, wait, no. I'm from the future. I'm a member of the Legion of Superheroes. No, wait. No, I'm from Earth 2, but not this Earth 2. I'm from like pre-crisis Earth 2, and I'm the only survivor, and that's why everything's so weird. And, you know, like pretty much what every fan of Power Girl was saying is like, who the heck is this character? Where's she coming from? And this kind of helps to gel that. And ever since then, I think she's pretty much been grounded as a Earth 2 character. Like in the New 52, where she's from Earth 2 and she's actually Supergirl there. It does a good job of establishing who Power Girl is in the first couple of issues. So then after that, you can get into all the mayhem. Like Ultra Humanite rips New York City out of the ground and Power Girl has to go fight him and he tries to, you know, cut her brain out so he can put his brain in there. And it's really nice because it gives you an idea of who Ultra Humanite is. Like, personally, I always thought he was just kind of this lame Gorilla Grodd or Monsieur Mala clone. But in this, he actually gets a character, he gets a backstory, he gets friends, and then Power Girl fights him and she knocks him into like the science equipment with all these chemicals and stuff, and he's just staying down. She's like, you wuss, I didn't even hit you that hard. And she pulls back the equipment and these chemicals spilled all over him and he was electrocuted and he's been horribly, horribly burned. And she's like, wow, I'm sorry about this. That's, in fact, one of the themes. You know, Power Girl does fight crime and evil, but most of the time, she really has no clue what she's doing. She does almost as much harm as she does good. And she's got this sidekick named TERRA, and some of the villains go like, geez, how unoriginal are you? You know, you're calling yourself TERRA. There's already been a TERRA. She was with the Teen Titans. She died. And can't you at least call yourself TERRA too? You know, the book is very aware of all the comic book conventions and it makes fun of them mercilessly. So it makes the characters more real in a way. It makes them more human. And this was super refreshing.
The verdict.
Before I read this book, I came from a New 52 marathon. You know, Batman, The Dark Knight, Superman, Wonder Woman, Justice League, you know, all this doom and gloom. And it's like, oh, wow, how great, you know, a fun comic book from DC. The artwork is nice, too. It's, you know, it's that typical DC fare from the late 90s, early 2000s, and I don't usually like it. But for Power Girl, it's right on the money. It's playful, it's got lots of little hints, and it's easy on the eyes. Also, the price is pretty good. You get 16 single issues for $17, so a little more than a dollar per issue. So if you like fun books that don't take themselves too seriously, but don't do it at the expense of the characters, you should definitely give this book a try. It's really about a girl trying to find herself and trying to do what's right and failing every once in a while and then, you know, fixing her mistakes. So, you know, it's a very optimistic, fun book with a strong female lead. You should definitely give it a try. So there you have it. That's my review of Power Girl Power Trip. Please like and subscribe. Share this video with your friends. Check out this video over here. Also, if you want to get this book, I've left you a link to the Amazon down in the description below. I'm David Marcel. Thanks for watching my comic book obsession. See you next time.